stronger religion, and we don't call it job.
Okay, listen, let her answer.
Yeah, take who? Take you. Not me. No one can take me. I'm more English than you.
All right.
I'm born in Baghdad. I'm any more English than you.
All right.
So, shit. Tell me someone take him. Take me where? It's free country.
This is why alcohol is no good for you.
Yeah.
Even a Muslim.
No. You're a liar. Why you take Quran Kareem and Zawrun, at least? Why?
It's embarrassing, man.
No, you're embarrassing. You're embarrassing. Okay, tell him. Okay, tell him to bring the Quran Kareem. 8,000 Quran Kareem Muzawwar.
Can we continue now?
Fact, we call proper English. Quran Kareem.
You win.
Last week, no, I'm not winner.
What are you?
I'm not winner. I'm not loser. Drop out Quran Kareem on the main and you play on it. Why?
Stay quiet.
They deal with each other.
You didn't answer my question, so you have to answer my question first. Okay. Hatun, she went all around the houses. I asked a very simple question. She made a claim that the Quran today is different to the one that Muhammad revealed. I asked for evidence. There is no evidence. She admitted she doesn't have Muhammad's as a Quran. Yeah? This was her claim. This is her whole flag in the ground here. She has no original to compare it to. So my question is very simple. We can do the same to the Bible. Yeah? We can take their manuscripts and we can compare them. We'll show you the fabrication. So when we make the claim that the Bible's been fabricated and corrupted, we support it with empirical, observable, testable evidence. Now, she brought the claim with regards to the Quran, trying to, if the Bible's like that, the Quran must be. Unfortunately, no, it's not. Because we don't rely on manuscripts yet. We have people today who memorize the Quran from the time of Muhammad. Now, let's just understand what would happen if this change would occur that she's claiming. Islam spread from Morocco to China. Now, if one person in Morocco changed the Quran and started reciting differently, started adding something differently, we would have two Qurans today. You could produce that Quran from Morocco with this verse, and we'd bring a Quran from China, one from Sweden, one from Mongolia, one from the US, and one from good old Blighty. And we'll compare them, and we'll see the differences. You would have to go to the Hafiz of all of these places and tell them to change it at the same point. But we don't see that. And corruption by nature spreads. It doesn't go back on itself. So if the Quran was corrupted from the beginning, we should see the fruits of it now. We should have Quran saying this here, Quran saying that there. Just like we see with the Bible. Now that is what evidence of true corruption is. Whose is this?
I told you, it is actually a shame that you are telling us we don't have the Quran from time of Muhammad. We don't have the Quran from time of Abu Bakr. We don't have the Quran from time of Uthman. Why not? Why Muslims were not capable to collect their books? Muslims have been in the power since Muhammad. Where is your Qurans? Why don't you have them? Why don't you have them? That's a very good question to answer, sir. And yet you said today, if you travel to Morocco, to different countries, everyone is reciting the same Quran. That's not correct. That wasn't the case in the time of Muhammad, and that is not the case in the time of, in 2017. In time of Muhammad, people had a disagreement regarding the Surah 25, and they were reciting the two different Qurans. It is the same, another Surah, which caused Ubay bin Ka'b to have doubt in his faith. Thanks to Muhammad, man of the peace just strikes Ubay bin Ka'b in his chest, and suddenly Ubay bin Ka'b decides to follow Muhammad. That's just amazing. So, can you please just tell me, what is your reasons? In 2017, you don't have the Quran from the time of Muhammad, you don't have the Quran from the time of Abu Bakr, which Abu Bakr compiled. You don't have the Quran from the Uthman. Why don't you have them? Can you please tell me you failed to answer my question previously? Surah 9 verse 128, 129, Surah 33 verse 23. Were they in the Quran of Muhammad? Were they in the Quran of Abu Bakr? Where are those ayats, sir? Also, can you just tell me?
Writing,
I am amazed that you are attacking the Bible.
Why
because
the Bible,
as a Christian, I am talking about my very minuscule.
Oh my God! You know what? You talk rubbish. Back to your Bible. What do you want for Quran?
Okay, Hatun again. Mm. She's verified for us. Thank you very much, Hatun. That she doesn't have a Quran that she compares to her Bible. Quran as a manuscript form. So she has no evidence to support what she's saying.
Yeah,
this
you.
Is her claims.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Now she thinks she can read the Quran and quote to me verses as if I'm Jazaki and I can know all these verses she's talking about. I've no idea what she's talking about. What I can say without a shadow of a doubt, whatever is in the Quran today is in the same what Muhammad SAW revealed 1400 years ago. And if you want to challenge that, produce your evidence. Because the burden of proof is on the claimant. Okay?
Thank you.
I have no issue with that. As for this memorization, talking about, oh, go to Morocco, go to China, I challenge you, go to Morocco. Find me someone reading Surah Fatiha with an extra verse. Find me someone reading Surah Al-Baqarah with a less verse.
I
challenge you. Yeah? We're not talking about variations in the styles of presentation. We're not talking
Islam.
We're not talking
Aruf.
We're talking about corruption, adding, changing verses.
Thank you.
Yeah? You've made the claim. Your claim is this, and we'll go back to the original claim. The Quran today is not the same as what Muhammad revealed, yet you have no way to verify that. It's nothing more than your subjective opinion. And of course it supports your biased opinion, what you believe. Because you don't like what the Quran says, because it challenges what you believe. The lies you've been spun. And we know that you believe is based on fabrications. I'll say it again to you. We have empirical, listen atheists, we have observable, empirical, testable evidence that proves the manuscripts of the New Testament are corrupt. They have been fabricated, they have been added to, and we can prove that. So why you're challenging the Quran with no evidence, yet you have empirical evidence for what you believe, and yet you still stand on it?
Yeah.
That's hypocrisy again.
20 more seconds.
I like the 20-minute, 70-second silence. Let it resonate. Think about it, contemplate, reflect.
Take a breath.
She got no evidence.
I am amazed. I am amazed. No answer. No answer. Did Muhammad recite Surah 9, verse 128 and 129? A Muslim missionary tells me I don't know that. That is very, very, very simple thing. Comes from how the Quran is compiled. Yet Muslim missionaries tells me I cannot recall them from my mind.
Whoa, sorry, I'm not going to respect 2 minutes. Don't misrepresent what I said. Don't misrepresent what I said.
Did Muhammad recited this Quran?
I said this. Everything in the Quran today was what Muhammad SAW revealed. Don't misquote me. I didn't say I don't know. I said it is. Don't lie about me.
Yeah, thank you.
For 2 minutes. Continue. Okay, don't misquote me, don't lie about me. Thank you.
So, my questions have not been answered. Surah 9 verse 128, Surah 9 verse 129.
I answered you, I said yes.
Surah 33 verse 23. Why those surahs were edited in the Quran later, those ayats edited in the Quran later, according to Sahih Bukhari 6, 509, 5010. So, since you didn't even touch what happened regarding the Surah 25 and which Surah 25 is the correct version, let me show you some different Qurans. When you don't even need to go to China, just go to the Middle East. And it is shame to Muslims that they don't even have their earliest manuscripts. I give up on the Muhammad, I give up on the Abu Bakr, not even Uthmanic manuscripts. Here is one of the Quran. It is Al-Susi's Quran, which is different from the Hafs Quran you are reading, sir. I would love to know if you can tell me why are you reciting the Hafs Quran? Why do you think Hafs Quran is reliable? Here is another Quran. This is the Abi Jafar's Quran.
We've got an extra 2 seconds. Right. Ready?
Okay.
As interrupted, apologies for interrupting, but I cannot stand it when people lie about me. All right, I said, whatever's in the Quran today was revealed by Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If you want to challenge that, produce your evidence. Keep quoting Bukhari, Bukhari, Bukhari. First thing I'm going to send out Bukhari. It's only 95% correct. We don't say it's 100% perfect, yeah? No one's made that claim here yet. You seem to be standing on it. All right. First of all, elaborate on what you're saying. Don't tell me verse 9:23 to verse 9:24. Why is that there? Tell me the verses you're referring to, yeah? And tell me how you know they're missing from the previous Quran. And this thing you just quoted here, yeah? Show me the extra verses added in the Quran that's not in the other Quran. Just show me the verses. All of us from day one, from the beginning of this conversation, produce your proof. You brought this book out, this beautifully compiled file. You opened it up as if we're all bamboozled with hafs and wash. Yeah? Show me the difference. I'm lying.
I didn't show the hafs and wash.
What did you show me? What did you show me?
You didn't
I didn't have a clue what you were doing. Because it had nothing to do with my question. I asked you to do me one thing. Show me the verses that have been added. You're saying Bukhari says a verse has been added. Yeah? Which verse has been added? I say you've misunderstood Hadith and the Quran. Because you're not an expert on either.
And Bukhari is dealing with Hadith and Quran.
So, a Muslim at Speaker's Corner, a Muslim missionary makes a claim they don't trust the Sahih Bukhari. I am amazed.
I didn't say that. Don't misquote me again.
I
said, we do not believe as Muslims. No Muslim here, no Muslim believes Sahih Bukhari.
You are taking my time.
Well, I have to.
No.
Stop
well,
lying about
sir,
me. No. I'll interrupt when you lie.
When it comes to your time.
I'm not going to waste my time refuting lies.
Sir,
all right? I'm not going to waste my time refuting lies. I'm not going to waste my time refuting your lies.
Didn't you say 95% of the Sahih Bukhari is reliable?
I'll tell you exactly what I said. All right, I'll make it easy for you. No Muslim here. Not one of them believes.
It's my turn.
Yes, but you're lying about me. You're lying about me. The clock has stopped. No. I'm not going
to
waste.
You have to wait.
I'm not going to waste my time refuting lies. No, I'm not. No. No. Unfortunately, no. No. You continue like no. No. Refuting lies. She says each time. No. You lie about me. I'm stopping you. All right. Halas. All right. Here's what I said to you. No Muslim here. Any Muslim here think Sahih Bukhari is 100% reliable?
You did not say that.
Not one.
You are lying.
Right. So what did I say? 95%. Yes. Who agrees with me that Sahih Bukhari 95%? Yeah, that's what we believe, right? So, understand that point. I never said I don't trust Bukhari. So don't make lies about me, please. Continue.
Here's the thing. I'll speak my 2 minutes. You wait, and then you speak.
I will not wait if you lie.
Because you're lying about Bible.
I will not wait.
No, sir.
If you lie about me.
This is not a shopping
center. I will not wait if you lie about me. I don't care, madam. I won't care. I will not wait.
2 minutes.
Madam. I will not respect the time if you lie about me. Understand that principle. It's a very simple principle.
Don't lie.
Why should I waste my time refuting her lies? Why am I going to waste my time refuting her lies? Then she'll say, oh, you didn't answer my question. Scared. You're the one hiding behind the camera. You're the one hiding behind the camera.
You look ridiculous.
I'll tell you what, you can come next. You can come next. You can tell us why the Bible's reliable, yeah?
You can tell me why I lie. It's the same God of the Bible or not.
It's calmed down. It's calmed down.
Muhammad the Prophet.
Calm down.
It's calmed down.
That's good.
It doesn't accept the fact that she's lying on his behalf.
So, Sahih Bukhari.
Yes.
It is called Sahih. It is called Sahih. As Sahih Bukhari compiled that, he already discredited 99% of what he collected. And then he kept on 7,295 of them. If Muslim missionaries don't even know how the Quran compiled and then takes this, oh, we don't trust the 5% of it, we trust only 95% of it, I would love you to tell me what is it makes you that you do not trust Sahih Bukhari, volume 6, 509, 510. Just respond to that and then I'll continue, sir.
Tell me what they are.
You don't even know what is Sahih Bukhari 510 and 509.
No, tell me.
Can you stop the clock and then I read it for him? Okay? Sahih Bukhari 509, 510. Let's read it. narrated Zayd bin Thabit,
which verse is it?
Abu Bakr ibn Sadiq sent for me when the people of Yamama had been killed. Right. A number of the Prophet's companions who fought against Musalima. I went to him and found Umar bin Khattab sitting with him. Abu Bakr then said to me, Umar has came to me and said, casualties were heavy among the Qura of the Quran, those who knew the Quran by heart, on the day of the Battle of Yamama. And then I am afraid that more heavily casualties may take place among the Qura on the other battlefield, whereby a large part of the Quran may be lost. Large part of the Quran may be lost. Therefore, I suggest you, Abu Bakr, order that the Quran to be collected. I said to Umar, how can you do something which Allah's apostle did not do? How can you do something which Allah's apostle did not do? By Allah, this is good project. Umar kept urging me to accept his proposal until Allah opened my chest for it. And I began to realize that good in the idea which Umar had really realized. Then Abu Bakr said to me, you are a wise young man and who do not have any suspicion among you. You used to write the divine inspiration, Allah's apostle. So you should search for it, the fragments of the scripts of the Quran, and collect it in one book. By Allah, if they had ordered me to switch one of the mountains, it would not have been heavier for me than this ordering me to collect the Quran. Then I said to Abu Bakr, how will you do something Allah's apostle did not do? How will you do something Allah's apostles did not do?
He did. Wrong.
He wasn't bothered.
Not true.
Abu
wrong.
Abu Bakr replied,
wrong.
By Allah, it Kataba, is a good wrong. Project. Abu Bakr kept on urging wrong. Me to accept this idea until Allah opened my chest.
No, now you just read another hadith about the same thing. You're repeating it. You're repeating yourself.
Sahih Bukhari is repeating. Abu Bakr kept on urging me, accept his idea until Allah opened my chest for
him. Abu Bakr never had choose. It's a Muhammad who choose.
Abu Bakr and Muhammad. So how do you understand that?
Skulls, thin white stones, and also from the man who knew it by heart. Until I find the last verse of Surah Tawbah, Surah 9, with the Abu Kuzama. I did not find two verses beside him. It was only he who knew that. And then when you come to the next hadith, 5 on 10, you see.
Oh, you're not reading again.
You see.
No, we've had enough. We've had enough.
Thank you. Yes.
The viewers can only take so much.
Thank you very much.
No. We get the gist. So how do you understand that?
Zaydi was right. So
you would tell me how you understand that.
So,
back again.
Yeah. Oh. So since I just made you to be familiar with your Sahih Bukhari hadith.
No, I know. I know you're referring to.
And I would love you to tell me. Since
you did,
it's my turn. It's my turn.
You had your turn. Yes, you did. You asked your question. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. It's my turn.
No. You stepped in.
Listen, she had her time. She didn't answer my question. Then she read the Bukhari, and now she's preaching again.
No, you stepped in when I was.
No, you finished.
Turn.
You said, answer my question.
It's on the camera. It's
you stepped in when I was
speaking. You invited me in. You said, answer my question. About Bukhari, I'm answering your question.
You stopped at you back to zero.
I would love to know.
Thank you very much.
I would love to know where does this Surah 9 verse 128 and 129 come from? Where the Surah 33 verse 23 come from?
Whoa.
I would love you to give me what is your criteria that you are discrediting the hadith, Sahih Bukhari 5%.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, first of all, how do you understand that? I'll let her do that. How do you understand that?
It's your 2 minutes. When it's finished, it's my turn.
All right. Evidently, if that's your proof, then you clearly don't. you have no clue. All right. First thing, the hadith is talking about the Quran and about the Hafiz dying. Okay, which is fine. Alhamdulillah. Now, if the verse is in the Quran and there was a criterion that Abu Bakr had was that two people who'd memorized it and two people who'd written it down, yeah, come together, then it would be put in the Quran. If they didn't have those witnesses, it wouldn't be in the Quran. If it's in the Quran, alhamdulillah, the witnesses. Now, this is just one man talking. I didn't find this. It's not every Sahaba. It's not everybody. It's just one person who he didn't know. Yeah? And I'll say again, the whole principle of this conversation is what? That Liz made the initial claim that the Quran we have today is not the same as the Quran that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam revealed. Hatoon has come with a complete red herring trying to make a claim that, oh, there were some people struggling to find verses of the Quran. Where do they come from? The clue is in the hadith. Clearly, Hafiz did know it, and therefore it passed the criteria, and therefore it's in the Quran. I don't even understand why you're wasting my time reading the whole hadith. SubhanAllah. What do you think the hadith proved? All it proved was the fact that, yes, there was a commission for the Quran to be called together, and some of the conditions was two people who've memorized it. Yeah, two people who've memorized it and who've written it down. Yeah? If it's in the Quran today, then it was in the Quran then. I do not see how this supports your position, which you've accepted you have no evidence for. This is your reason, Bukhari, which doesn't support you. It's actually against you because you're assuming only one person back then had information on new people. Yeah? And you're trying to make this and grow it in. Now, you said I lied about the Bible manuscripts. I didn't lie. I don't. This is not a belief. This is not subjective. I can bring you proof. I can bring you two manuscripts and show you the difference.
So, you have not responded to me where this Surah 9, verse 128 and 129 comes from.
I just did.
Where Surah 33, verse 22-3 comes from. Are those verses which Muhammad recited? Which Muhammad recited? I've got the same problem for Surah 1.
I am not going to give our chance to talk about Muhammad. Way back to the Pope of Roma. We asked Pope of Roma, take the Bible. Pope of Roma, Vatican, take the Bible outside. Tell the Christianity reality. Why should talk about Abu Bakr, about Umar, about Ali? I have to talk about the Pope of Roma. The Pope of Egypt. Go outside to the Christianity, tell the truth.
Go back. For a nice coffee,
no, of course I got right. Thank you. I can talk about Omar A. We should talk about Papa of Roma. Where the Papa of Roma? Vatican, he can look the real Bible outside. He cannot, darling.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes, okay. 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 Okay.
My question still stands. Surah 9, verse 128, Surah 9, verse 129, Surah 33, verse 23. Also, I would love to know who was the one who made the decision that Surah Fatiha is the part of the Quran. Who is the one who made the decision that Surah 115 and 116 is not part of the Quran? And I would love also you to explain it to me. What is happening in certain? Let me just read a couple of hadiths.
This whistle.
Ubay's petition has been rejected. And I would like
this is Jay Smith's successor.
So it's my turn. Why Muslims are not able to stand still and just answer the questions? I am amazed what Islam does to people. Disrespectful Muslims. That's, I guess, what your prophet has taught you. So, I ask you a question. What is it that 5% of the Sahih Bukhari is not reliable? What is your criteria for that? I ask you, why today you use the Hafs Quran? Okay? You have not responded to any of my question. Here is the Associates Quran. This is just the first page. And I'm gonna give you some examples and I would love you to back that up. Please explain it to me. Surah 1, Surah 115 and 116 as well.
So she's scrubbing around in the dark, right? She knows she has no proof. So now she's throwing out straw men left, right, and centre. She's doing the classic shotgun strategy. She's trying to hit me with so many things that I can't answer them all, and it looked like, then she'll say, see, it didn't answer my question. Yeah, that's how she does it. Okay, Surah Fatiha, what's that got to do with whether or not it was in the original Quran or not? Who decided it or not? I don't understand that. Second thing, Surah An-Nas, Surah Al-Falaq, because she's referring to 115, 116. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said himself in Sahih Bukhari, that two of the greatest verses of the Quran is Surah An-Nas, Surah Al-Falaq. So there's your evidence for that. What was your other nonsense? God, you have so much nonsense, I can't remember it. Hafs Quran, I don't know what you're going on about. Let me know what you're talking about. Again, I just want to go back to the original point that I asked Liz, and she went running to you. Where's these differences? Show me the differences. Show me the extra verses. Show me what you think has been added. Show me what's been changed. Like, I'll show you. I'll show you how the story of the adulterous woman was added to Bible manuscripts in John's name as forgery. I'll show you Acts 8:37 was added. I'll show you the forgery. I can show you. I've got empirical, observable, testable evidence. And here's the hypocrisy list and Hatun. You stand there scrabbling in the dark, trying to understand the hadith, trying to make them support your view, yet you are blatantly ignoring explicit evidence that proves your Bible is corrupt. It proves it without a shadow of a doubt. You don't have an original. Your oldest is 4th century. We know from the 4th century to the 6th century it's been corrupted. We know from the 6th century to the 16th century it was corrupted. So what happened between the 1st and the 4th, we don't know. But what we do know is happening. Now I ask you, show me in the Quran where it's been changed. Show me the addition. Show me the added verse. Don't ask me who decided to put Surah Fatiha in it. Or why is Surah An-Nas, Surah Al-Falaq? And this Sahaba said that shouldn't be in there. Another Sahaba said it should. That's got nothing to do. Complete straw men, complete red herrings. Yeah? You can't provide evidence, okay, so you're scrabbling in the dark.
It's my turn. Let me just respond to the Bible. Today, you can tell me John chapter 8 shouldn't be there because my Bible tells you, man, because you should be thankful to my Christian scholars who puts together 5,839 Greek manuscripts from the 129 AD for you to see them. I can go to the bookshop, buy a Bible which tells me what are the versions, what are the with the critical edition of, what are those variations. But here is the Quran. Here is the Quran. Can you show me where is in this Quran stoning adultery verses? Please do check it and show it to me. Because according to Islamic tradition, this verse should be in the Quran, yet it is not in the Quran. Where is that verse? I would love you to tell me, according to Sahih Bukhari, where is this rajam verses, stoning verses? I would love you to tell me where is the 213 verses of the chapter 33? Where are those verses? Still, you fail to tell me where did you get the Surah 9, verse 128 and 129? You fail to tell me where did you get the Surah 33, verse 23? You fail to tell me, even though Muhammad said Surah Fatiha is the most important Surah in the
Quran. No, Falak an-Nas.
Yet.
Don't misquote me.
Yet. People in the early century did not take the Surah Fatiha, did not take the Surah 115 and 116 as part of their scripture. So I am just simply asking, who are the ones who make a judgment on that after Muhammad is already end up dead? Who are those people? Your traditions, your Sahih Bukhari, 95% reliability of the Sahih Bukhari according to you.
Okay. She keeps saying I didn't answer. I'm going to do it again. If the verse is in the Quran and it's from Muhammad, if you want to challenge that claim, produce another Quran like it. The Quran as it is today, now if you want to claim about the verses of Rajab, show me a Quran with the verses in it and then show me the Quran without it. Show me. You can't. Now you make this claim about the manuscripts in the Bible. Oh, we're honest, we show you. You didn't know until the end of the 19th century. Up until the 19th century, you thought John 8 was the word of God. Now you know it isn't, right? Only because you discovered the Code of Sinaiticus that exposed you. It's not like you've been honest, you've been exposed. Don't you get that? It's not like you've been, oh, well, you know, we're going to be truthful with you. No, you were exposed. The Bible needed to be revised. Because why? Because it contains fabrication, which is not the word of God. Now, my question is this. How can you claim that from the first century to the fourth century, it also wasn't corrupted. How can you make that claim when we know it is being corrupted? You can't, because you don't have a manuscript earlier than the fourth century, a complete manuscript. So don't act like I'm lying about your manuscripts yet. Don't act like you're being all honest Christians. No, you were exposed. And guess what? The King James Bible still lies. It ignores your oldest manuscripts. It still claims John 8 happened. It still claims Acts 8:37 happened. Believe it or not, it still believes the forgery of the 16th century, John 1:5-7, there are three who bear witness in heaven, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. They even believe that's the word of God. That's the lie. That's the corruption. And you stand on this. So you're hypocrites, because if you want to challenge the Quran because you can't understand this hadith and you think this hadith means this, understand one thing about hadith. We can prove through hadith that some Sahaba thought some things were Quran when they weren't. Yeah, and they made mistakes. We know that. Because why? Because we know what the Quran is. And when they thought that, they realized it wasn't. Yeah, so we can prove that as well. Yeah, and I'll say it again to you, Liz. You made the claim. You've got no evidence to support your claim. Your reasons are flawed. The hadith you're quoting don't support what you're saying. Yeah? No, because it was your claim, Liz. I'm not letting you hide behind a skirt. I'm talking to you, Liz. You made the claim. Hatun's trying to support you miserably, but you made the claim. Don't make claims you can't support. I don't think your backup can support it, because you didn't.
It's my turn.
Wrap it up.
So, no Quran from the time of Muhammad, no Quran from the time of Abu Bakr, no Quran from the time of Uthman. From 125 AD to 2017. I have got, as a Christian, 5,839 Greek manuscripts, which confirms my Christian doctrine. Oh, of course. And before that, I have got a Muslim holy book, confirms Quran came to confirm the previous books. Sadly, Allah doesn't know. Maybe John chapter 8 wasn't the part of the Quran. Sadly, Allah doesn't know. 1 John chapter 5, one verse is not part of the Quran. Allah says, Christians has nothing else to stand unless they've got the gospel. So, when you look at the Islamic tradition tells us, and you fail to tell me, where is your verse, where is your Quran which talks about the stoning verses? Islamic tradition tells me, eternal word of Allah was eaten by a sheep. Islamic tradition tells me, Allah was not even capable to protect his eternal word from an animal. Islamic tradition tells me, actually, we don't have the Quran, perfect Quran from Muhammad, because he didn't even bother to compile the Quran. The Quran we've got today, there are 26 different Arabic Qurans out there. It contains 45,339 variations. Let me show you some of the variations, because my dear Muslim friends don't even know. I would love you to first of all explain me what's happening in Surah 2, verse 118.
We don't know. Anyway, okay. So Hatun again is scrabbling around. She did so many shotgun tactics again. She made this strawman argument that the Quran confirms the Bible and the Gospel. It doesn't matter, the camera's listening. We play the man, not the ball. Sorry, play the ball, not the man. All right. We deal with the stupid arguments, not the person. All right. They can't help it. All right. Anyway, please don't distract me. I'm trying to finish this off. All right. I'm trying to think of the nonsense she said again. Just 1 second. Yeah, 1 second. I've got her in record because she shotgunned me, easy. 1 second. Yes. Eating the goat. All right, she's talking about this nonsense about a goat eating the Quran. She clearly doesn't understand that the Quran was memorized. So if a goat can eat as many pages of the Quran, like people memorize, they don't forget. They're not in Tarawih and all of a sudden, oh, the goat takes a page. Oh, we forgot the verse. It doesn't work that way. Yeah? The Quran didn't need to be compiled as a book in the time of Muhammad because he was there revealing it and the people were memorizing it. It was only afterwards it needed to be because of the different recitations and such and the way Islam spread. What else is there? Your New Testament, the doctrines, yeah. Show me anywhere in the Bible the doctrine of Trinity, please. Show me anywhere. Show me any manuscript that says God is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit and co-equal distinct beings. Show me anywhere your scriptures support your doctrines. Show me anywhere where Jesus said he died for your sins. Show me anywhere. Yeah, show me original sin anywhere in your scripture taught by Jesus. Show me. Yeah, show me this stuff. Show me where the Holy Spirit is God, equal to God. Show me. You can't. Don't say the script manuscripts support your doctrine. They don't.
There is no answer to my questions. Even though ship.
We're going on again. We're going on again now. Are we going to continue?
Last one.
That was a wrap up, but you're continuing.
Well, it wasn't a wrap up, so.
The moderator said it was. Yes. Is it wrapping up? That was a statement.
Last statement now?
Well, that was the last statement.
Let's go.
If Quran has been eaten by the God, yet people memorized it, why it's not here, man? Why it's not here? Why it is not in the written of the Quran? How many Muslims today recite that passage? My questions were standing today. You cannot tell me you've got the Quran from the time of Muhammad. You are memorizing the Quran, what Allah revealed to Muhammad, because that's a big lie. Muhammad didn't even remember the Quran. Muhammad didn't even compile the Quran. Abu Bakr didn't have, you don't have the Quran from Abu Bakr. You don't have the Quran from Uthman. And you failed to answer my question. Who was the one who made the decision that Surah Fatiha, Surah 114, 115, and 116 is part of the Quran? Who is the one who makes a decision that Surah 9, verse 129 and 128, Surah 33, verse 23 was the part of the revelation Muhammad received? According to Islamic tradition, no, it's all full mess. Today, there are 45,339 variations in 26 Qurans, and they are pretty messed up.
An example?
There are lots of examples. Let me give you some examples, sir. Surah 98, verse 6, creatures versus innocent. Creatures versus innocent. That's the first example. Let me give you more examples. Since I've got 45,399, I should be able to give you more references.
One more. 15 seconds.
All right, here we go again. She keeps saying I didn't answer. Watch the video, I did answer. I answered completely with regard. First of all, I said Fatih has a red herring. Then she's claiming that Abu Bakr, we don't have Uthman. Here's my question to you. What's the Quran we have today? Where did it come from? And if it, I've told you before, the nature of corruption, it spreads. So what Hatun's trying to claim is the Quran we have today wasn't compiled in the time of Muhammad. So what were they reading then? What was recited in Tarawih then? What was in Ramadan? What were they saying?
Don't know.
Okay, what were they saying?
Muhammad
okay. What should see? Because we know today we have people. It's my time, is it? Have some respect. Christians, have some respect, please. Christians, have some respect, please. Christians, have some respect, please. Have some respect, please. I didn't interrupt her speech.
You didn't interrupt
her. No, it's a fruitcake.
You didn't interrupt her also.
Okay. So we have to ask this question, what were they reciting in Ramadan, what were they reciting in Tarawih, what was it when they prayed their Salah, what was it? Because if it was something different to what we today, see, the Quran has been memorized from people today, we have people today who've memorized it from their fathers, who memorized it from their fathers, who memorized it from their fathers, all the way back to the time of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We don't have this issue. So therefore, we'd see the changes, we'd see a different Quran. Nature by corruption spreads. Corruption by nature spreads. So if it started off corrupt, as Hatun claims, today we should see results of that corruption. So where are these 26 different Qurans today? Today, where is the extra verses? Where are the extra verses? It's my time, it's not your time.
Know,
it's not your time.
I
give him chance, yeah.
So where are these extra verses? We should find them. My initial response to Liz was, produce your evidence. Produce your evidence. Prove to us the Quran has added verses. She can't. Now again, I'm going to call them hypocrites to their face. You're a hypocrite and you're a hypocrite. Because if you're so concerned about manuscripts being corrupted, why are you ignoring your explicit corrupted Bible? Why are you ignoring that? If you so care so much about the preservation of manuscripts, why do you ignore the explicit corruption and fabrication found in your manuscripts, exposed by the later manuscripts we discovered? Yeah? Why do you ignore that? Because you're both hypocrites.
Is that it?
Thank you, Hamza. Examples? Anyone wants to? I just end up in a conversation where a Muslim missionary was talking with a Christian. My friend Lizzie, and he was talking about how reliable Quran is. he was making, we are reading the Quran, which is what revealed to Muhammad. Yet, we know Islamic tradition tells us that's not true. We know Islamic tradition tells us, actually, Muhammad didn't even remember the Quran. We know Islamic tradition tells us Muhammad didn't compile the Quran. We know Allah wasn't even capable to protect the Quran from even an animal. And we know from Islamic tradition that people forgot the verses, they didn't remember. I emphasized regarding the Surah 9 verse 128 and 129 plus Surah 33 verse 23. According to Islamic tradition, those verses are edited later. Yet today, if you go out and then buy a Quran, which is read only by Quran only Muslims, you will see Surah 9 verse 128 and 129 is not there. But the point is that as Muslim missionaries comes out and then talks about how Quran is perfect, how those recitation goes back, today we've got nothing, written form of nothing which takes us back to Muhammad. We've got nothing which takes us back to Abu Bakr. We've got nothing which takes us back to Uthman. We've got just nothing. Yes, Muslims tell us people memorize it, but that's not the point. We know Ubay bin Ka'ab and Masud wasn't even agreeing what they're supposed to memorize. As we look at the Islamic tradition, we see there is a big gap between what happened and how did Surah Fatiha end up in the Quran. We know why Surah 114 and 115 and 116 did not even make to the Quran. Muslim missionaries brings up the verses and chapters which my Bible tells me there are the variations. For example, John chapter 8 regarding the woman who caught in adultery. They know this because my Bible tells them. Christian scholars have been very open about their manuscripts. I can go and buy those Bibles which gives me the critical additional. Yet, none of the Muslims can provide book Quran for me which has the Surah which is regarding the stoning the adultery. Surah regarding the suckling adults. Those verses are not in the Quran yet. In some Muslim countries, they are still practiced. Yet, they were practiced in the time of Muhammad as part of the Quran. But you know what? Today, 2017, there is no Quran out there we can chase back to Muhammad. There is no Quran out there we can chase back to Abu Bakr. There is no Quran back today we can chase back to Uthman. Yet, the same argument they bring to us regarding Bible is not reliable. They look at my manuscripts and they see those things. And it's amazing. As a Christian, we talk about it. If I don't have my Bible with the critical additional, they wouldn't know that. Yet, on the other side, remember, Quran came to confirm the Bible. Quran confirms John chapter 8. Quran confirms 1 John 5. Quran confirms everything in the Bible. Quran never discredits the writings from the Bible. But in 2017, Muslims turned up the speaker's corner and Muslim missionaries, without any shame, tells me that my Bible is corrupted, without any shame. Do they know much better than Allah? Do they know much better than Muhammad, who put his hand down and said, I believe in the Torah? Do they know much better than the first rightly guided caliphs? No. Shameful of them if they still make a claim that Bible is not word of God because it contains lots of variations. That's just shame. So, Muslim missionaries, just move on. We know Quran has been corrupted. We know Quran has been changed. And you will never know what Muhammad recited. You will never know that. But you need to come back to the eternal word of God, Lord Jesus, who tells you who God is, who makes the way to come to the God. Yet we look at the Bible, which Quran came to confirm the Bible, tells you, if you do not worship Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to spend eternity far from Him. And you don't want to be in that position, because your eternity was that important. God the Son came and nailed himself on the cross for you. So let's move on from the textual variations. Let's come to the big topics. Let's come and talk about what our faiths are teaching.